U.S. installed more solar energy than any other source of electricity in the first quarter of this year. And it's becoming increasingly popular here in Florida, where there is usually no shortage of rays. But President Trump's trade war might change things a little bit later this year.
This is the Sunshine State.
Living in Florida, going solar was a no-brainer for Carol Lopez Bethel. 3 years after installing solar panels on the roof of her 1950s-era Coconut Grove home, the sun powers her fridge, her washing machine, her AC, and more.
The lights that are on right now are free. They're coming from the sun, and we are not creating any pollution. We're not imposing ourselves in any negative way.
Lopez Bethel likes that she's helping the environment while saving big time on her monthly power bill.
Prior to solar, it would have been between $150 and $200.
And now you're paying $28.72.
Yes.
With those savings and the federal tax incentives currently in place, the average $30,000 solar system will pay for itself in about 7 years. But to some, the future of solar looks a bit cloudy. President Trump has slapped tariffs on imported solar equipment, driving up costs. Florida-based solar company Blue Chip Energy went under recently after selling hundreds of customers solar panels that didn't work and may have been unsafe. The Florida Department of Business and Professional Regulation sent CBS4 a list of solar providers with complaints filed against them since 2015, most for licensing violations. Lopez Bethel says she did her research before choosing a contractor.
Of course, I rolled the dice. There was a leap of faith.
She went with Miami-based Golden Solar.
I guarantee you, you're going to use energy. But the question is, are you going to buy it from your local utility, or are you going to benefit from the sunshine hitting your rooftop?
The utility companies like FPL see solar as a threat and backed a 2016 amendment to limit rooftop solar expansion. The measure failed. Solar advocates cheered. Darren Golden encourages his customers to shop around, using the price of dollars per watt as a comparison. He says homeowners interested in solar should be planning to stay in their house for at least 7 to 8 years, should have a large flat roof surface with direct exposure to the sun, make sure they're working with a licensed contractor, and get references. Lopez Bethel can monitor her system online, charting the production of each panel on her roof. Her panels often generate more power than she actually needs.
You are actually returning power to the grid, and FPL has to rebate that back to you.
You sell it back to FPL?
Essentially, yeah.
How cool is that? That's what's known as net metering. FPL deducts the amount of energy you sell back from your monthly bill or credits future bills in the same calendar year. Net metering applications are available online. And this was a very interesting story to work on. And I learned about these federal tax credits that are in place right now, but that could go away at any moment. So this seems like this is a really good window,
it's a good window of opportunity
if you're thinking about it.
Yeah, and especially here in Florida where we have sun pretty much every day.
It's a no-brainer.
Thank you, Rick.